Theater Guild's production of Don't Be Afraid of the Dark. For the announcements, we would like to acknowledge our staff member, Mike Ackerman, a Homebelt District Theater fan who passed away suddenly this week. We will now observe a moment of silence. Thank you. Please observe the fire exits on the sides and at the back of the theater. In case of an emergency, please proceed through those doors. The use of flash photography is prohibited as it is a distraction to the actors. And smoking is prohibited on school grounds. This show is performed in two acts. There will be one 15-minute intermission after act one. Please enjoy the refreshments in the commons provided by the Homebelt Creative Arts Association, our parent support group. Also, for those audience members sensitive to light, there will be a strobe light effect in the second act of the show. And finally, texting, talking, and other disruptive behavior will be extremely detrimental to the enjoyment of this production, and the cast and crew have worked very hard. Please excuse yourself from the auditorium if you find it necessary to respond to a message. The phones also interfere with our sound system. Please turn off your phones now. We thank you for your anticipated cooperation and enjoy the show.
Sitting room, Mr. Will.
Thanks.
It's a nasty night, sir. You won't get an argument from me.
Did I hear correctly? You're Mr. Whittle?
Zip Whittle.
We weren't expecting you until tomorrow.
Oh, well, the letter I got from the attorney said I should be here tonight.
Let me take your coats and hats, sir. I'll hang them out to dry.
Thanks. Oh, and what's your name?
Skull, sir.
How's that?
Skull. It's a peculiar name, I admit. Still, there it is. Your late cousin liked my name very much. Sometimes I think that's why he hired me.
Oh, because he was a mystery writer.
Do sit down, Mr. Little. Make yourself comfortable.
Don't mind if I do.
You're a writer too, aren't you, Mr. Whittle?
This is the housekeeper, Mrs. Bones.
Skull and Bones?
As Skull said, there it is.
Nice place you guys got.
Your late cousin liked this place very much. He was happy here, or as happy as he could be under the circumstances.
There are creaks and moans. It's an old house.
Yeah, see that? A waiter.
I beg your pardon.
I'm a waiter, not a writer.
I misunderstood. I thought your cousin said writer.
Waiter, writer, housekeeper, what's the diff? I mean, we're all human beings, that's what I say. I hustle trays at the fish shanty. Manhattan. It's trendy. No reservation, no table, no exceptions.
If you say so, sir.
I don't mind admitting I'm excited about being here. The Shadows. I've heard about this place before. You know, family gossip.
Gossip?
Oh, well, Cousin Sebastian may have been a recluse, but he was well known at one point. Comes wet. I mean, this is about his, but I've always known that he's been related. You know, this is Bones, when people stare at me, I get kind of nervous. And I get the feeling that there's purple goo on my chin. Something wrong?
I'll get a broom and dustpan.
Broom? Dustpan?
Someone tracked mud on the floor.
Oh, that must be me.
Before you arrive.
Oh, company. What a boy. It's Murder, new thriller by Sebastian Sly.
Good evening.
Good evening, Miss.
I'm Miss Cooper.
Yes, Miss Cooper. It will follow me. The sitting room, Miss Cooper.
Oh, hello, I'm Lila Cooper.
Hi, I'm Zip Whittle.
I think we're distant cousins.
We are. You must have got the same letter I did.
Oh, from the lawyer, Gloria Parr?
That's her.
Nice to meet you, Zip.
Same here.
I'll get the luggage from your car.
But you'll be drenched.
I'll take something from the umbrella.
you ever seen one of his plays?
No.
I saw one a few years ago, a community show. All about a woman who thought she was a vampire.
Vampire?
But she wasn't a vampire.
Good.
And she was a zombie.
Hasn't Sebastian had some imagination?
To say the least.
I hadn't even known Cousin Sebastian had died until I got the letter. It was sudden. Very sudden. Hello?
This is Bones, the housekeeper.
Have you been housekeeping long, Mrs. Bones?
Long enough.
Sebastian Sly loved this house. It was in his blood. He said he'd never sell the shadows. If either of you inherit the place, I trust you'll feel the same way. It's a lovely house with muddy footprints. Oh, I'm so sorry. I thought it might be the hall. Oh, my goodness.
She needs before we got here.
Oh. I've kept the handkerchief. I thought you might want it as a memento.
Handkerchief?
The last years of your cousin's life, he took to wearing a handkerchief.
There's nothing unusual about wearing a handkerchief.
Over your face? He became quite eccentric. More than usual. Said he was sick of people of hypocrisy. That's him in the picture, sitting in his swivel chair. I always want to know what Cousin Sebastian looked like, but this doesn't help much.
Are there any other pictures of him?
I've never seen any.
Why wear a handkerchief over your face?
Said he wanted to put a veil between himself and the world.
Goosebumps.
Once he retired here to the shadows, he never left. Stayed in his room with the handkerchief over his face. He wore it when he took his meals.
Dinky.
What a strange place you wrote must have affected him. The other way around. Your cousin wrote strange plays for a good reason. He was strange.
Yeah, never thought of it like that.
Shall I show you to your rooms now, Miss Cooper, Mr. Whittle?
Mrs. Bones was telling us about her cousin's fashion used to wear a veil over his face.
We never mentioned it. He had a temper.
Wild temper. Are there other villages already?
Miss Parr said you and Mr. Whittle were the only relatives.
Then we're the only people in that house?
There are others. Velma Cringe, an old actress. She worked in many of your cousin's plays. An excellent screamer. Down on her luck.
And Miss Winkler. Who is Miss Winkler?
Miranda Winkler. Your late cousin's secretary.
Who can that be? Miss Parr told us he'll be arriving tomorrow.
My letter said I should get here tonight. About 10?
Yeah, see, here. Here, I'll show you what I got. Therefore, it will be necessary for you to arrive at the shadows at approximately 10 o'clock.
I actually parked outside for half an hour. I didn't want to be early. Letter sounded so precise.
So?
I'm going.
Come to think of it, the door. There wasn't any bell to ring.
Your cousin refused to install one. It's a miracle he allowed the telephone. Television was out of the question. That radio is over 50
because he liked the old-time radio.
On the radio are some of his place scripts. He was working on a new one at the time of his death.
Well, that's interesting. What was it called?
He called it When Apples Lead.
Catchy title.
Sorry, I asked.
So Yeah, but
It would take a bull elephant to bring it down. Don't believe anything those two say. They're inclined to exaggerate.
But there's nothing to worry about.
Nothing. Now I will show you to your rooms and finish with locking up.
Why couldn't I have been related to a dentist?